We are learning more tonight about a stolen car suspect who slammed head-on into an oncoming car just north of Modesto, which claimed another life today.
Deputies say they were in pursuit of a car theft suspect yesterday in Stanislaus County. The driver slammed into another car on Claribel and Coffee Roads. KCRA3's Sharkina Shams is live at the county jail in Modesto now with new information about that. Sharkina?
Well, Lois, 26-year-old Francisco Martinez is now being held here in downtown Modesto at the Stanislaus County Men's Jail. The CHP says he was under the influence at the time of yesterday's accident, and Stanislaus County authorities believe the reason he was running is because of his lengthy rap sheet. One day after a parolee was accused of causing a crash that eventually led to three deaths, we are learning more about why he was allegedly running from law enforcement officers. According to Stanislaus County authorities, 26-year-old Francisco Martinez was wanted for not checking in with his parole officer after a conviction of drug possession last year. He'd previously been convicted of burglary, resisting arrest, and possession of stolen property. Authorities say Martinez and another man, 20-year-old Brandon Ellis of Riverbank, were driving this stolen Mitsubishi Montero Sunday afternoon when they led deputies on a deadly chase.
Both the suspects in the vehicle had previous contact with law enforcement, so they knew what was coming. They knew they were going to get arrested.
Deputies say as soon as the suspects were spotted, they sped away. The CHP says the Montero at one point was traveling faster than 90 miles per hour.
As the suspects were driving erratically, the deputies were falling behind. They were getting ready to terminate, but between the short time of the pursuit, the suspects crashed. The deputies were about a half mile behind them.
The suspects crashed into a black Ford Taurus, killing two victims, Heather Miller of San Leandro and Stephen Jackson of Modesto. The accident also left suspect Brandon Ellis dead.
All they had to do was stop. They probably would have been arrested for just possession of auto theft, and one of them was a parolee at large. Now they're looking at one of them's dead, and the other one's looking at least three murder charges.
And back out here live, 26-year-old Francisco Martinez faces three counts of murder, two counts of auto theft, one count of felony DUI, violation of parole, not surprisingly, and one charge of fleeing law enforcement. We are told he may be arraigned as early as tomorrow. I'm Sharkina Shams, live in downtown Modesto. Dave and Lois, back to you.
Sharkina, anything that the Sheriff's Department could have done differently here?
Lois, we tried today to talk to the family members of one of those crash victims. Not surprisingly, they were in no mood to talk about this. Very, very shaken up after this happened yesterday. However, deputies for their part insist that no, they say that they followed all proper procedures. They also say they will do an internal investigation at the Stanislaus County Sheriff's Department, and also the CHP is investigating this crash. So if there is anything that those two deputies could have done differently, CHP will come back with that information.
All right, Sharkina, thank you. Elsewhere.